Where did you get the name Elvis the Pelvis?
From somebody just like the character that's writing this article here.
Do you have any idea who?
No, sir, I wish I knew. I don't know. Of course, I don't like to be called Elvis the Pelvis, but, I mean, it's one of the most childish expressions I've ever heard coming from an adult. Elvis the Pelvis, but if they want to call me that, I mean, there's nothing I can do about it, so I just have to accept it. Uh-huh. It's like you got to accept the good with the bad with the good.
Okay. Back to the quotation. We're no prude, but we might suggest a gift in these our 14,000 mama girls who, as if it were a fetish, are vocally and mentally and genuflecting to Elvis Presley. A solid slap across the mouth. Rao means a slap across the mouth to these girls. Have you any comment to that?
Yeah, but I don't think I should say it, you know.
Okay. This isn't over the air. This is for TV guy.
TV guy. I don't think I should say it, you know.
Okay.
Because I'm a singer, but not a fighter.
No, they also ask. I ask, where did you pick up your style?
Well, sir, I don't know. I really don't know. I just started out doing what I'm doing now.
Have you ever seen anybody else do it?
No, sir, never have.
Have you got any techniques you've added since you started in show business, or is these all?
No, sir, I've been doing the same thing. You know, I've only been in the business, about a year and a half.
Uh-huh.
And I'm doing the same thing that I started out doing. I haven't added or taken anything away.
Did your first appearances, I mean, did your first success occur in records or in personal appearances?
My records started selling very well, and then I...
Your records sold before you made any success as a performer?
Yes, sir.
So do you think that your gyrations merely add to the performance you give? Or do you? Do you think that the movements you make have made you famous, or your style of singing?
I don't know, sir.
Have any idea?
I can't answer that.
Okay. There was I read a clipping somewhere where you were attributed as saying that the whole roller, you would.
I have never used that expression. But that's another deal. See, I belong to an Assembly of God church, which is a holiness church.
Uh-huh.
I was raised up in a little Assembly of God church.
Uh-huh.
And some character called them holy rollers.
Oh, I see.
And that's where that got started. I always attended a church where people sang, stood up and sang in the choir and worship God, you know.
Uh-huh.
I have never used the expression holy roller.
Do you still attend church?
Every opportunity I get. I don't have as much opportunity as I used to because I'm on the road most of the time.
In the holiness church, do they have peppy music?
Peppy music?
Mm-hmm.
They sing hymns and spirituals. They sing spiritual songs.
Do they sing them at a fast tempo?
Yes, sir, they do sometimes.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been going to that church?
Ever since I was old enough to walk.
About 5 or 6, huh?
Yes, sir.
And do you think you transfer some of that rhythm into your...
That's not it. That's not it at all. There was some article came out where I got the jumping around from my religion. My religion has nothing to do with what I do now.
Uh-huh.
Because the type of stuff I do now is not religious music. My religious background has nothing to do with the way I sang.
Do you recall the first time you sang in public? You remember when the first time you
sang
in public?
Yes, sir. It was back when I was about 10, 11 year old. I was in an amateur program at a fair.
And did you use a lot of gyrations then?
Well, I wasn't doing the type of songs I'm doing now.
Oh.
Nobody knew what rock and roll was back in those days.
But when you hear rock and roll, it gets you on the fire, or?
Not when I just hear it on the radio. When I'm doing it on the stage, you have to put on a show for people.
Yeah.
In other words, people can buy your records and hear you sing, and They don't have to come out to hear you sing. You have to put on a show in order to draw a crowd.
Yeah.
If I just stood out there and sang and never moved a muscle, the people would say, well, my goodness, I can stay home and listen to his records.
That's right.
But you have to give them a show, something to talk about.
Now, in this show, we've established that it is a show that you put on. Now, how did you get the idea for the rapid amount of action? Have you never seen anybody move around as much?
No, sir, I never have. I just...
Never had any old showman advise you ought to do it?
Nobody has ever told me.
Uh-huh. Where is the first time that you used the rapid action?
My very first appearance, after I started recording, I was on a show in Memphis where I started doing that. And I was on a show as an extra added single, a big jamboree in an outdoor theater, an outdoor auditorium. And I came out on stage and I was scared stiff.
Mm-hmm.
It was my first big appearance in front of an audience. And I came out and I was doing a fast type tune, one of my first records. And everybody was hollering and I didn't know what they were hollering at. Everybody was screaming and everything. And then I came off stage and my manager told me that they was hollering because I was wiggling my legs.
Mm-hmm.
And I was unaware of
who was your manager?
Bob Neal.
Bob Neal. Okay.
And so I went back out for an encore and I did a little more and the more I did, the wilder they went.
Three a day.
On the vitamin? I was thinking, I thought you were about 3 a day show.
Yeah.
Okay. Now we're down to the question. In other words, you picked up your style when they appreciate just a little wiggle. You figured they'd appreciate more with a little more wiggle, and they did. So now you really give them the works, right?
That's right.
Okay.
I'll say this, sir, before we go any further. It's back on the subject we were talking about at first. Talking about reporters, there's a rumor has gotten out that I don't have no time for reporters, that I just answer with a yes or a no. And it's very untrue. I have my first one yet to turn down. I've never turned down a reporter. I've never turned down a disc jockey. I know that I can't visit radio stations like I'd like to, but I don't have time. And I have never turned down a reporter. I have never been sassy to one. In fact, I've never been sassy to anyone. And I've always stayed and talked to them as long as they wanted to talk. And I admire them. Well, because they keep us in business. I mean, the newspaper columns, the reporters, the disc jockeys, we all work hand in hand.
Do you recognize or do you have any idea one way or the other whether the criticism has helped or hurt your career?
I don't know, sir. I wish I knew.
Would you agree with myself in the opinion that the criticism has helped skyrocket you with the defense coming to your rescue every time somebody knocks you, every knock with a boost, in other words?
Well, that makes a lot of sense.
Here's a new question now. What is your reaction to the NBC comment after they learned Sullivan had hired you that you are just a flash in the pan?
Maybe they're right. I don't know. Nobody knows. In fact, if I knew, I would be a mastermind. I'm not.
Okay, that's a good answer. Next question is, what about your acting career? Do you have any plans for an acting career?
Yes, sir, I do.
You have a contract now with?
I have one with Paramount.
And how long is it?
7 years.
7 years, and how many pictures?
Picture a year.
Can you give me an approximation of the amount of that contract over the 7 years for the amount of fee that you'll receive?
No, sir, that's never been released.
Have you ever had any experience in acting before?
I've never read a line in my life.
How do you figure on going about learning to become an actor?
Sir, I don't think you learn to become an actor. I think maybe you've got a little bit of acting talent, you develop it. I don't think you learn to be an actor. If you learn to be an actor, in other words, if you